var du med, da dieselmotorerne begyndte at slå benzinmotorerne ud i lastbilerne? I så fald husker du sikkert, at man næsten synes, at bilerne gik gratis. Så lidt kostede dieselolien dengang. Den forestilling har holdt sig længe. Men i dag er dieselolien så sandelig ikke billig. Næh, i dag skal man køre fornuftigt for at spare på tankindholdet. Og det er jo en god tanke. Vi skal høre lidt mere om det der med lastbiløkonomi, men jeg skal også byde på lidt amerikansk truckin' musik. Og den første skive kommer her. Up and down the two coastlines, I travel everywhere. From Portland East to Portland West and back along the line. I'm going out to the place that's best, an old hometown of mine. Oh, 8 more miles in Louisville will come into my view. 8 more miles on this old road, it'll never more be blue. I knew someday that I'd come back, I knew it from the start. 8 more miles in Louisville, the hometown of my heart. Somewhere that you like best of all. Now mine lives down in Louisville. She long and she is tall. She's the kind that you can't find around and through the land. I'm on my way this very day to win her heart and hand. Oh, 8 more miles in Louisville will come into my view. 8 more miles on this old road, it'll never more be blue. I knew someday that I'd come back and knew it from the start. 8 more miles in Louisville, the hometown of my heart. Det var 8 Miles to Louisville med Osborne Brothers. Per Arne Wiklin har kørt tømmerbil, siden han var en stor knægt. I dag arbejder han som testkører ved Volvo lastvogne i Göteborg. Og han har lidt at sige om, hvordan man starter en moderne lastvognsdiesel.
Vi har gode førere her i Norden. Men efter min mening er der for mange, der fusker med koldstarten. Man skal ikke bare springe ind og vride nøglen om. Uforbrændt brændstof skader miljøet og forøger slitagen på motoren. For at eliminere denne røg har Volvo udviklet en elektrisk forvarmningsanordning, og den sidder i indsugningsrøret. Og den skal altid anvendes ved den første start om morgenen. Hvis motoren virker sær i starten, så vindes intet ved at presse den. Altså lavest muligt tomgangsomdrejningstal efter start, mindst i 1 minut. Siden forøger jeg omdrejningstallet noget. Og kører den varm yderligere 3 til 4 minutter. Har jeg intet læs, er andet eller tredje gear måske det rette at starte i. Men med læs må jeg vælge et lavt gear, så jeg ikke behøver at slide på koblingen. Og hvis det er nødvendigt, så tøv ikke med at starte i krybegearet eller laveste gear. Det er det, det er der til. Hvis motoren er kold, når man starter, bør man starte blødt og forsigtigt. Stemplet er let metal, og det udvides betydeligt hurtigere end foringen. Så spillerummet mellem stemplet og foringen bliver for lille, og hvis vi vedbliver at give fuld gas op ad bakke med kold motor, Ja, så kan vi få en rivning, som forøger slitagen katastrofalt, eller i værste fald en stempelrivning. Nej, trill blødt og let i begyndelsen, så får motoren en nænsom opvarmning.
Diggy-diggle-eye and diggy-diggle-low. Diggy-diggle-eye, oh, diggy-diggle-low. Everyone knew he was a foe. No one else could ever show so much love for diggy-diggle-low. Every chance, show their love with every glance. Diggy diggle-eye, oh, diggy diggle-low. Everyone knew he was a foe. One else could ever show so much love for diggy diggle-low. Diggy diggle-eye, oh, diggy diggle-low. Everyone knew he was a beau. No one else could ever show so much love for diggy diggle-low.
Det var Mats Rothberg, som afløste Per Arne med Diggy Diggy Low. Nu er vi kommet i gang med vores lastbil. Hvis det var en ældre model, ville du måske køre den, så den lyder sådan her. Men har du en Volvo af den nye generation, så er dit alt for højt omdrejningstal. For sådan her skal det lyde. Kan du høre forskellen? Altså, sådan her lyder en tidligere model. Men de nye motorer kan du køre med så lave omdrejninger, at det lyder sådan her. Det er klart markeret på omdrejningstælleren, at det er her, du har den bedste økonomi. Og kraften eller drejningsmomentet slår også fint til hernede. Det mærker du snart. Ja, sådan skal det altså lyde fra motoren. Og fra din radio skal det lyde sådan her.
That big eight wheel rolling down the track means your true loving daddy ain't a coming back. I'm moving on. I'll soon be gone.
Soon be gone.
You were flying too high for my little old sky. I'm moving on.
Moving on.
Big loud whistle as it blew and blew. Said hello to the Southland, we're coming to you. I'm moving on. Oh, hear my song. You had the laugh on me, so I'm a setting you free. And I'm moving on. Mr. Engineer, take the throttle in hand. This rattler's the fastest in the southern land. Keep rolling on,
rolling on.
Keep a moving on.
Moving on.
You're gonna ease my mind, so put me there on time. Keep moving on. I've warned you, baby, from time to time, but you just wouldn't listen or pay me no mind. I'm moving on. I'm rolling on. You've broken your vow and it's all over now, so I'm moving on. Someday, baby, when you've had your play, you're gonna want your daddy, but your daddy will say, keep moving on.
Moving on.
You stayed away too long.
Way too long.
I'm through with you, too bad you are blue, so keep moving on.
Move on, move on,
move on. Det var Billy Cramer med Moving On. Skønne rytmer, når du mover on gennem landskabet. Faktum er, at det kan være et problem, at der er så stille i de nye Volvo-førerhuse. Du hører simpelthen ikke, at motoren går på for høje omdrejninger. Men du ser det, naturligvis, på omdrejningstælleren. Den nye omdrejningstæller med det grønne felt. Økonomifeltet. Når du kommer over det, altså det grønne økonomifelt, så er det på tide at komme ned i omdrejninger. Og komme ned i omdrejninger, det gør du lidt ved at lytte til The Wonderfuls' How Do I Spell Relief?
You think you feel bad, honey? Feel of me. Sometimes I feel like I ain't got a friend. It's hard to find someone that's true. When I feel downhearted, when I'm feeling blue, how do I spell relief? Y-O-U. Oh, Y-O-U are for real me, me. You are the one that I turn to in times of tribulation. On the shores of my life, when the thunder clouds turn black and blue, when my ship starts sinking, oh, what do I do? I just spell relief, Y-O-U.
Nu skal vi tale lidt om at køre op ad bakke. Her kører du også i det grønne felt på omdrejningstælleren, økonomifeltet, og giver ned, når omdrejningstallet bliver for lavt. Du giver jo ned i flere omgange, og til slut kommer du ned i så lavt gear, at du får et kraftoverskud. Det betyder, at du kan accelerere, hvis du giver den mere gas. Men lad være med det. Hørte du, hvad jeg sagde? Lad være med det. I stedet for giver du lige netop så meget gas, at du stadigvæk ligger inden for økonomiområdet. Den tid, du eventuelt sparer ved at gå op til maksimale omdrejninger, den er ikke værd at tale om. Nej, kør grønt, kør systematisk. Lyt nu til The Room at the Top of the Stairs med Mats og Rankerne.
I know a place where love comes easy, and I know a woman who meets me there. She takes my hand and gently leads me, and we go up to the room at the top of the stairs. I close the door and she pulls the curtains. When we make love, it's a private affair. I've been around, so I know for certain there ain't no room like the room at the top of the stairs. When we climb up the stairway,
kommet op ad bakken, og hvis det fortsætter med plan vej, så giver du op og fortsætter kørslen som sædvanligt. Men går det ned ad bakke på den anden side, skal du naturligvis lette på højre foden og lade lastbilens tyngde give fart ned ad bakke. Den hastighedsstigning får du praktisk taget gratis. Ja, du kan naturligvis hurtigere komme op i fart ved at give gas, men så må du i stedet for bremse en masse energi bort, når du kommer længere ned ad bakken. Altså, op med højre foden, når det går ned ad bakke. Og går det for stærkt, så hold tight med Kenny Starr.
Hold tight, I wanna dance with you this whole night. I hope the music never slows up. I hope this place don't never close up. No, no. So come on, hold tight, 'cause you're the only one who feels right. Girl, I know it's now or never. I wanna dance with you forever. Yes, I do. So hold on tight, never let me go, baby, 'cause I
yourself in motion. You're tearing my emotion right in two.
Så op med højre foden, når det går ned ad bakke, som jeg sagde. Ellers skal du måske flytte den til bremsepedalen, inden du er kommet ned ad bakken. Men som sædvanlig anvender du først og fremmest motorbremsen. Og når du bremser med hjulbremserne, så skal du gøre det i flere omgange med korte, bestemte indbremsninger og lad tromlerne køle af i mellemtiden. Lad man bremserne ligge an eller slæbe hele vejen ned ad bakken, så bliver de let for varme. Men det ved du selvfølgelig. Det skal jeg jo ikke sidde her og lære dig. Det kan være jo regne ud. Apropos regne ud. Her kommer lidt multiplication med rankerne.
Now when you see a gentleman be round a lady be buzzing, just count to ten and then count again. It's sure to be an even dozen. Multiplication.
Multiplication,
that's the name of a game,
the name of the game.
And each generation,
you know
we play the same. And that's two butterflies casting their eyes, both in the same direction. But you never guess that one little guess could start a butterfly collection. Multiplication.
Multiplication,
that's the name of a game,
the name of the game.
And each generation. Play the same. Let me tell you now, I say one and one is five. And you can call me a silly fool, but you take two minks and add two minks. You got a one mink coat. When a girl gets coy in front of a boy after three or four dances, you can just bet she play hard to get to multiply your chances. They call it multiplication. That's the name of the game. And
each generation,
you know the play the same. You hear me talking to your mother nature. It's a clever girl and she lies on habits. You take two hairs with no cares. Pretty soon you got a room full of rabbits. Parakeets in between tweets sometimes get too quiet. But do have no fear, cause soon you'll hear a barricade's right to stride.
Multiplication.
That's the name of the game,
the name of the game.
And each generation,
you
know they play the same. They call it multiplication. That's the name of the game,
the name of the game.
And each generation,
you
know they play the same. They better.
Når det gælder om at køre, så tankindholdet rækker langt, så findes der en enkelt hovedregel, du skal følge. Og det er at køre roligt og jævnt. At accelerere en fuld lastet bil for fuld gas, det koster penge. At køre, så man skal bremse energien bort, det er heller ikke særlig smart. Derfor skal man så meget som muligt mindske farten ved at lette på gaspedalen. Prøv at køre, som om du ikke havde nogen bremser. Så skal du se. Du vil få en optimal husholdning med tankens energiindhold. Farligt for trafikken? Nej. Skulle du pludselig få behov for at sætte farten ned, bruger du naturligvis bremserne. I en faresituation går sikkerheden før økonomien. Og i en sådan situation er det godt at have kolde bremser, som giver fuld bremseeffekt.
We're screaming through the valley where the Nishnabotna flows, through the mud and crud and cornfields where the marijuana grows, across the railroad tracks of Persia, down the hills and up the dale, past CJ5 with a four-wheel drive and Smokey on my tail. Well, he picked me up at exit 12 on the I-680 ramp. I was doing 67 per when I rumbled through his trap. He commenced to whirl his flashing lights and he made his siren wail. I slipped on down to four-wheel drive, Smokey on my tail. Now I got racing stripes and dual pipes and Smokey's got a Ford. Got a mill with a four-pot carb, you know, but Smokey's stroked and bored. Well, the chase was on, but I had the edge with a rig that'll never fail. Got a CJ5 with a four-wheel drive, Smokey on my tail. Yeah, he was. Well, I dropped on down at Granny Low and I made a hard right turn. My big old fat commando tires went slashing through the corn. Well, the tassels blew and the kernels flew and it looked like yellow hail. Just cooking alive in a four-wheel drive, Smokey on my tail. Well, we went screaming through the valley where the Nishnabotna flows, through the mud and crud and cornfields where the marijuana grows, across the railroad tracks of Persia, up the hills and down the dales. My CJ5 and four-wheel drive, Smokey on my tail. Look out now, here he comes. Oh, we gonna get it on now. Don't hit that fellow with a banjo. We gonna swim this here creek now, Smokey. Yard wide and foot deep. Nishnabotna River, they call it. Might have to winch out. Gonna do a wheelie on that there gopher mound now, Smokey. And you dig it, Smokey. Got four on the floor and four in the air on that one, didn't we? Goodness gracious. About to bust my shocks. That Jeep of mine made Smokey whine, his rig was made of lead. He's mired in 14 feet of mud, so he radioed ahead. I pulled up onto the blacktop and went crashing on through the rail. Sakes alive, I had 25 more Smokies on my tail. Now I had racing stripes and dual pipes, and Smokey had a Ford. Had a mill with a four-pot carb, you know, but Smokey's stroking bored. Well, the race was on, but I had the edge with a rig that'll never fail. Got a CJ5 with a four-wheel drive setting out back of the jail.
Dette var Four Wheel Drive med Seawee McCall. For at du ikke skal tro, at alt det, vi snakker om her i programmet, er ren teori, så kan jeg da sige, at der er foretaget praktiske køreprøver med forskellige førere, og her fik vi et eksempel på, at man kan spare en halv liter på 10 km udelukkende med en bedre køreteknik. Men inden vi går videre med det, kommer Osborne Brothers tilbage med Highway Heading South.
I'm gonna rest these chilly bones in the southern sunshine and live where the weather's warm until I die. When I cross the Dixie line, I'll throw away my coat. Goose down underwear will have to go. I'll never live again where the weather chills you to the bone. I'm tired of living like an Eskimo on a highway heading south.
southern sunshine and live where the weather's warm until I die. Well, on a...
En god chauffør skal selvfølgelig have den rigtige bil til jobbet. Men hvis økonomien skal være i orden, hvad er så den rigtige bil? Ja, her kommer Bengt Lindén fra Volvos laboratorium og snakker om nogle almindelige fejl, som ødelægger brændstoføkonomien.
Denne lastbil har vi med vilje udstyret med en del typiske fejl, som giver ekstra højt brændstofforbrug. Det kan være interessant at se lidt nærmere på, hvad de forskellige fejl koster i ekstra brændstof. Bagakslen for eksempel har forkert udveksling, når man tænker på, at det er en typisk fjerntrafikbil. Den har starttrækkraft i overflod, men med 80 km i højeste gear roterer motoren med alt for højt omdrejningstal. Vi mener, at det koster ca. 0,4 liter ekstra alene for en forkert valgt bagaksel. Derefter kan vi se på, hvad der sidder på hjulene. Det er grovmønstrede vinterdæk. Men er det ikke økonomisk at nedslide det sidste af vinterdæk på tør vej? Nej, ikke hvis man ser på brændstoføkonomien. Et groft dækmønster betyder, at bilen ruller tungt og bruger mere brændstof. Med udelukkende vinterdæk bruger denne her bil 2-3 deciliter ekstra per 10 km. Og det endda under forudsætning af, at dækkene har rigtig lufttryk. Sløser man med lufttrykket, forøges forbruget yderligere. Denne bil har 1 kilo for lavt lufttryk over det hele, og det koster 2 deciliter ekstra per 10 km. Desuden ved vi, at denne bil går med tungt gods for det meste. Og der er det helt unødvendigt at have en opbygning på 4 meters højde. Det giver unødig luftmodstand, specielt på hurtige veje. Det var en god idé at sænke højden 30 cm. Forskellen i forbruget drejer sig om ca. 1 deciliter per 10 cm byggehøjde, så prisen for denne ekstra højde er 2-3 deciliter per 10 km. Kan man også mindske farten med 10 km per time, så sparer man 4 deciliter ekstra per 10 km. Og det samtidig med, at dækslidet aftager med 20%. Lægger man nu alt dette sammen, opdager vi, at vi sparer over en liter per 10 km. Hvad det betyder med dagens dieselpriser, kan man let regne ud. Og hvad det kommer til at koste med fremtidens priser, det kan man jo forsøge at gætte på.
Side. She said that she was headed to Houston, and I said I sure could use the ride. Two lost souls who needed saving, thrown together in life's storm. And when we stopped to rest outside of Dallas, sleep in each other's arms. Little did I know when I met her how my life was gonna change. Now the sun shines somewhere in Texas, but all she left me was the rain. Afraid that I would leave her. Maybe she needed just to go on alone. But at a men's room at a Houston truck stop, I came out and she was gone. Little did I know when I met her how my life was gonna change. She left me was the rain. Yeah, the license plate just said Texas.
Det var Geoff Morgan med The License Plate Just Said Texas. Den rigtige musik til jobbet, skulle jeg mene. Og den rigtige bil til jobbet, den har altså en passende motoreffekt, passende lastkapacitet, en passende kraftoverføring med gearinger, som giver den starttrækkraft og de fartressourcer, som du behøver for netop din type kørsel. Har du disse punkter i orden, så har du også den rigtige forudsætning for at kunne køre, så du får en fornuftig økonomi. Og en passende plade er If You Can't Give Me Love med Carina Wessmann.
Well, I've seen you before on a discotheque floor. You were driving me out of my mind. Oh, but I could have sworn that I saw something more in your eyes. Although you were surrounded by beauty and bounty, your glances intended for me. And though I tried to hide it, I found myself looking to see. Loving you took your chances, you made your advances, your touch took my breath away. But when you said hello, I read it a go where I had just one thing to say. If you can't give me love, honey, that ain't enough. Let me go look for somebody else. And if you can't give me feelings with old-fashioned meaning, then stay in love with yourself. If you can't give me love, 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 thing, but honey, I ain't looking for that. What I need is a man of some sort of aristocrat. Oh, if only you waited, or just hesitated, or maybe just asked me to dance. But you really don't know why I don't wanna go, and baby, that's why we don't stand a chance. So if you can't give me love, honey, enough, let me go look for somebody else. And if you can't give me feelings with old-fashioned meaning, then stay in love with yourself. If you can't give me love, if you can't give me love, oh, if you can't give me love, oh, if you can't give me love, oh, if you can't give me love, honey, that ain't enough. Let me go look for somebody else. And if you can't give me feelings with old-fashioned meanings, then stay in love with yourself. If you can't give me love, if you can't give me
servicesiden betyder også en hel del for økonomien. Bernd Abrahamsson kender til forholdene indefra på et stort værksted. Spørger du ham, hvad et autoriseret værksted kan gøre for at hjælpe dig til en bedre økonomi, så svarer han sådan her.
Ja, det må koste lidt at holde en lastbil i stand. En del vognmænd betaler unødigt meget for deres service, og dem kan man hjælpe. Man tager altså bilen ind med jævne mellemrum og renser den for eventuelle fejl. Man må i og for sig betale for service i hele bilens levetid, men slipper på denne måde for de store knald og undgår unødvendig stillstand.
Bernd har et godt råd til dem, der vil undgå unødvendige værkstedsomkostninger.
Min regel imod sådan noget er enkel. Hvis det lugter eller lyder anderledes, så skal du ikke fortsætte med at køre, men undersøge, hvad det er.
Hvis nu en fejl på bilen hverken lugter eller lyder mærkeligt, rolig, så bliver de alligevel afsløret, når den rutinemæssige grundinspektion foretages på Volvo-værkstedet. Sådan her, siger Bernd.
Jeg vil våge at påstå, at vores grundinspektioner er så grundige, at vi opdager alt.
Vi kan nå et nummer til, og det bliver en klassiker inden for trucking-musikken The Old Home Fill Up and Keep on a Trucking Café med C.W. McCall.
Well, Interstate 80, we was cutting the fog, just me and old Sloan. Old Sloan's my dog. We had an 18-wheeler with 10 on the floor and stereo, laying a strip. And then we spied a sign that says eat gas now. We decided to whip in and pick up some chow at the old home filler up and keep on a truckin' cafe.
Oh, the old home filler up and keep on a truckin' cafe.
Looking for Mavis.
The old home filler up and keep on a truckin' cafe.
Now we've been every place between here and South Sioux, and we've seen us a truck stop waitress or two, but this gal's built like a burlap bag full of bobcats. She's got it together. While she filled my tank, I said, thank you, honey. Name was Mavis, I gave her the money. Old Sloan just sat there watching and wagging and wishing. I says, you wait in the truck, boy. Then I went inside, she says, what'll it be? I says, a cup of your best and a number three. She came back with an order to go and a quart of hot sea and a bone for Sloan. I said, much obliged, old Sloan give a bark. I left her a buck and he left his heart. And the old home filler up and keep on a truckin' cafe.
Oh, the old home filler up and keep on a truckin'. Oh, the old home filler up and keep on a truckin'. Oh, the old home filler up and keep on a truckin' cafe.
Well, Saturday night, and we was trucking along. Yeah, me and old Sloan was getting it on. I said, Sloan, I've been thinking on a getting up a courage, and tonight's the night. Well, I popped the clutch, gave Tranny a spin, took the BB Town Ram, and slid on in to the old home filler up and keep on a trucking cafe.
Oh, the old home filler up and keep on a trucking. Oh, the old home filler up.
It never closes.
The old home filler up and keep on a trucking cafe.
Well, I got me stool, took a load off my shoes, made Mavis an offer that she couldn't refuse. I says, how'd you like to go for a ride with me and old Sloan and just have my truck washed? She allowed us that. Sounded like a whole lot of fun, but we was gonna have to wait until the dishes was done. And was it all right with me if she brought along her mother as a chaperone? I said, why not? Well, we geared that tranny into super low, and the four of us went to see a picture show. Yeah, I took him to the drive-in theater over by Pisgah to see True Grit. Saw the late, late show, old Sloan hit the sack, and then along about 2 o'clock, I hauled him on back to the old home filler up and keep on the truckin' cafe.
Oh, the old home filler up and keep on the truckin'. Oh, the old home filler up and keep on the truckin'. Oh, the old home filler up and keep on the truckin' cafe.
8 stools and a promise.
Oh, the old home filler up and keep on the truckin'. Oh, the old home filler up and keep on the truckin' cafe.
They got a real nice place there.
Yes, that is slut fra os for denne gang. Volvo og ja, takker for, at du vil høre på, og vi ønsker dig en fortsat god tur. Move on, folks. Kør grønt.